Hey, I'm glad you finally got back to me. I'm not gonna lie, for a while there, I thought that was it. I mean, I would have understood, because it was kind of sporadic and like weird. It's been such a long time, and it doesn't matter now, I guess. Yeah. That's all that matters. Conveniently, because be prepared. Just be. Actually, wait 1 second. These are for you. I didn't really know what to get you or what flavors you liked, but the lady behind the counter was super helpful. It was a whole moment, but at the end of it, I figured, these are beautiful. You're beautiful. What could go wrong, But anyway, we have a whole night plan. I say whole night, but it's not really that interesting. No, it's cool. You know what? Screw it. It's cool. All right, now come with me. We have a bit of a walk. Trust me, it's worth it. And open your eyes. What do you think? I don't know how you feel about heights and, well, the ocean, but I don't know, this is one of my favorite spots. Talk about it's just soothing, and it's just us, I don't know, sometimes I just come up here and when things don't really feel right, I come here and I can just sit here, hanging my legs over the edge and just be here. What I'm trying to get at is this is my spot, I guess. This is I've never brought anyone here before, and I mean it's Yes, it's kind of weird. Mean, if it was some like romantic movie, this would be cute, but I kind of just kidnapped you and brought you to a cliff face in a secluded area. But we can pretend it's a sappy romantic movie. I mean, I did give you flowers, so I mean. Brownie points. And over here, look what I have a bottle of. Now, I don't know if it's your favorite, but I heard you ordered it on the res at the restaurant on Monday, and I was. I mean, it's pretty good. I think I haven't tried it. I don't know. I'm nervous. I'm sorry. We've been friends for a long time, yeah. But up until recently, it was just friends. And I mean, I know that you're an amazing person, and despite that little attitude you put out. You're so sweet and you're beautiful. And when I think of you, I just smile, and I've never felt this before. And even during our stupid arguments or ridiculous attitudes, it's just there's no one I would rather share that with. I would only put up with your attitude like this. Like, if it was anyone else, I'd be out of here, trust me. But something about you. Anyway, would you like a drink? Did you bring? No, you. Oh, shit. So, I didn't bring cups. How do you feel about sipping from a glass bottle on a cliff face with me? I am very glad that that is your answer, because I think I need this glass bottle. No, please, help yourself. Yeah, no, it's probably not as good as the one you got from the restaurant, but I mean, Chef de Oak, right? You know, I've been thinking about when we were younger. Do you remember? World class history. I remember. I used to always get in trouble with the teacher, and you know, I'd always be causing mischief or just stirring the class up, just trying to have fun and have a laugh. But it always made it worth it when I would turn around to the back of the classroom and there you are, laughing, that big, goofy smile. I loved it. It made it worth it. I mean, it probably didn't reflect too well on my grades, but it was good fun. And I mean, I feel like that's really how we bonded, you know? What was that teacher's name? Miss Thickums, right? She was amazing. I really do miss her. It could be weird if I found her on Facebook and yeah, no, that would be weird. No, let's not do that. I don't know. I mean, she loved me, but I feel like that's crossing some sort of a line, you know? No, but it's nice to think back to me and you. Just how we were. Do you remember? Do you remember when we went camping? I'm still traumatized, right? But we went to Ladieswell. We were jumping off rock faces and diving into the water. And I mean, you were nervous, but you did it. But anyway. We were sitting around the fire because it was freezing. And me being me and inebriated, very close to the fire trying to get warm. And I was having a conversation with my friend. Yeah, exactly. It's with Rob. I'm glad you remember, but for the sake of the story, let me continue. I mean, let me finish. Leaned close. And out of nowhere, I just heard this screaming and this horrendous smell took over. And I swear to God, I thought I was like adrenaline kicked in and I was prepared to take down everyone, I was just ready. And then I started like really, really getting like hot and starting to stress out, like maybe there's some sort of like bushfire or, it was a fire restriction, so like no fires could really be allowed, but like we did it anyway because, I'm badass. And sorry, distracted. But after like a solid 15 seconds of searching around looking for the problem, I realized that my whole right sleeve of my hoodie was just like ablaze. It was no good. It's shocking. I got out of it with like minor injuries, nothing real bad, but I'm telling you, the arm hair just hasn't grown back the same. Do you remember? No, do you remember what happened shortly after that? Well, I mean, as usual, you were taking care of me, making sure my dumbass didn't catch fire again. And out of sure bad decision making, I got a little bit too close, and kissed you. My memory wasn't positively.
Bye.